Congratulations, North Carolina Classic Champions. Guys, I want to say congratulations on both being all tournament team and Devin for being MVP. Congratulations.
Our game plan was to shut them down defensively. As we all know, we didn't do that in the first half, but we came out here in the second half, locked them down, and came out with the victory.
How's the thought process in putting those plays together as you're coming down the court?
It just all happens out of instinct. I don't even think about it. If I see a move and it's going to work, I just do it.
For a championship game, both teams were very relaxed and were in very good offensive rhythms. I kind of said to the opposing coach at halftime, it was kind of a little bit of a, you know, we let you score, you let us score. I don't think either team really clamped down on defense. We have him on track to probably finish his career as the second leading shot blocker in all of San Diego history, probably to Angelo Chol. But I think more impressively, I think you hit on the button, is that he really alters a lot of shots. He takes people out of their rhythms. You notice when he comes out of the game, the middle looks a lot more open. The court looks more wide open. And so he does change the game. He makes people have to kick it out. Even more so yesterday than today, you could see guys almost really changing their arc, throwing the ball up, you know, almost 18, 20 feet up in the air.
There's some coaches that stand, some coaches that sit, but you tend to like to kneel a lot. What's the background of the history?
I started doing that because out of respect for the guys on the bench, the coaches and the team, you want them to be able to see the game. I always hated it if I was on the bench and I couldn't see the game if somebody was standing. So usually I'd like to sit like, you know, squat like a catcher, but my legs aren't as strong as they are. So I think it's morphed into a little bit of kneeling and praying.